Section 27 of Law Number 2004/16 of July 2004, creating a commission, enjoins it to popularize by all possible means instruments relating to human rights and forge a human rights culture in the people through education, information, debates, conferences, and seminars. In the Southwest region, the regional office of the Commission is on the front line of human rights struggle, fighting to promote and protect human rights within the national, local, and grassroots levels. The Commission gives voice to causes that have been ignored, forgotten, or marginalized. It raises legal awareness within targeted communities, often providing legal representation in high-risk or neglected human rights cases. This press conference is intended to motivate the involvement of the regional office in the investigation of alleged fraud into the university by the current mayor of Boya, Mr. Patrick Ekema Esunde. The present justification on the involvement of the National Commission in the fight against fraud in the University of Boya rests on several legacies. The idea that an individual is allowed to enroll in the university with one advanced level paper when several other applicants with two or more advanced level papers cannot be allowed to register for lack of the necessary cut-off points. The risk of dragging the reputation of the university into mud and thereby affecting the future of genuine students who have passed through the university. Lastly, it is overwhelming for a public figure to continue in office after engaging in a fraudulent act of this magnitude. Where people are denied access or where there exists disproportionate criteria in the admission of students in the university, tension is created in the community and this provides a fertile ground for violent conflicts. In order to address the foregoing, the Regional Office of the Commission embarked on a fact-finding to investigate allegations relating to Ekema Patrick's credentials. Section 3 of the law setting up the Commission provides the Commission with the means of action. It states unequivocally that in order to discharge its duties, the Commission may, in accordance with the condition defined by its rules or procedures, summon any party and all witnesses for hearing. Request the competent authorities to carry out searches and require the production of any document or evidence in accordance with ordinary law. Refer any offense noted in matter falling within the remit of the law to the Minister of Justice. In the light of the above mentioned section, the Regional Secretary wrote to the Registrar of the Cameroon GC Board, Dr. Humphrey Monono, requesting copies of ordinary and advanced level results for Ekema Patrick Esunde. From the results at our disposal, we can state boldly that Ekema Patrick Esunde frauded his way into the university. It is very difficult for us to ascertain whether it was done in complicity with the university.
Universities, University of Boya is ranked 200. We don't want them to descend from that position. We should expect UB to move forward, and all the efforts put by the authorities cannot be thwarted overnight. People have suffered to put in place to bring fame to this university, and we cannot allow an individual or group of people to destroy that reputation because they think that they have a right to go to the university with whatever documents. So I think that the commission has been able to establish
that we received several complaints relating to alleged fraud by the mayor of Boya relating to his academic credentials. And we thought that we should avail ourselves to Section 3, Sub 2 of the law setting of the commission, which requires that the commission should investigate such matters and require certain documents to be furnished to the commission. And we wrote to the Registrar of the GC Board asking him to furnish us with ordinary and advanced level resource of the said man, Ekema Patrick Esunde. From our analysis, we noted that the highest grade he earned in four attempts he wrote the advanced level was an A grade, followed by a compensatory the following year. Mr. Ekema Patrick Esunge has never passed the advanced level. And the question is, how did he find himself to the university, the prestigious University of Boya? We are unable to ascertain the complicity of the university in this fraud. But all we can conclude is that he misused his position as a staff of the Student Affairs Office to introduce falsified documents to earn a place in the history department. Since then, we can establish, and from the record we have in our keeping, that in 2007, he registered the advanced level but did not write. Having noted that he earned a BA in history in 2006, it beats one's imagination that someone with advanced level or with a degree earned in October 2006 will proceed to register advanced level in 2007. The documents speak for themselves, res ipsa loquito. And we cannot allow a fraudster of this caliber to manage our funds in our municipality. The population has been crying foul, 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 because we have noted over the years that instead of embarking on developmental projects for the benefit of our community, he spends time corrupting officials to support him, and that is why up till date he has an illegal firearm which he is unable, unable to furnish the public with a permit from the Minister of Territorial Administration or the President of the Republic. This has been brought to the attention of the Commissioner for Government, and no investigation has been opened for the past 6 months or more that we submitted our complaint relating to this firearm.